Tonight, the west wind carries the burning bones of the old Floyd place. Lit by the half moon, smoldering beams send mystic smoke signals. They settle over Leonardsville, invade open windows, and invite us to partake in the ritual. At the wake, we'll offer memories of those who've gone before, tell stories of how we got where we are. This hurts less than mourning the loss, whether by accident or act of God. Now, it hadn't been the Floyd place for as long as anyone could remember, but neither had the neighboring farms that used to belong to Walmsley and Wilson, Dunlap and Bibby, Supernaw, Gregory, Gochi, and Kennison. Not only are those names in the county's book of deeds, they're on the tongues of the old-timers who remember and retell the stories. Stories of bees in Harry's hayfield, bear cubs in the orchard, a first kiss inside the ice house, lightning striking Egg Mountain, summer boarders from Brooklyn, kitchen dances in midwinter, secrets and lies behind the barn. Morning brings steady rain and the fire's finally out. Pain remains for the new owners, whose stories were those of promise, not the past, as they tried to breathe new life into an old farm. The last carpenter to care for this house was Bernie Courtney some 50 years ago. The scent of his pipe tobacco lingers in the air, invoking the holy. While up at the stone house, the ghost of Gertrude Cook whistles a lament, an air she called Mother's Lake. The last of the burning bones becomes one with the fog and hovers in the valley over Trout Brook. Why do we cling to these bones? Those times when life was simple and life was damn hard all in one breath, why not let them rest in peace? Perhaps it's belief in a force that flows through us all. Or maybe it's just out of respect for the mystery we cannot explain. Thank you.